朋友，好朋友，傻瓜是我的好朋友。好朋友，好朋友，傻瓜是我的好朋友。傻瓜 you're my best friend。
We can find him, Shigua.
Dongua? Come out wherever you are.
Okay, game's over. You win!
I win! You said it, I win! Yeah! Once again, the big brother is the champ.
Once again, the big brother is a pain.
That was fun. Let's play again.
Sounds great to me, Shigua.
But let's up the stakes this time. How about... Loser cleans the clubhouse.
Whoops, oopsie daisies.
Hey, that wasn't funny, Jet-Jet.
Don't get your tail in a knot, Sagwa. We were just having fun. Maybe we should dump water on you. Your face is all dirty.
That's not dirt. It's her markings.
He knows, Shigua. He's just trying to make me mad.
Better get back to the palace so your mama can clean you up.
Mama? Oh my gosh! We have to finish the scrolls! She made us promise!
Your face is all dirty.
I looked this way for a reason.
Sagwa, hurry up!
Come on!
Whoops!
Hey, be careful, please.
What happened?
Sorry. Accident. Well, watch it the next time.
I don't see why we have to practice writing anyway. I'd much rather be practicing my gung fu. Yeah! Hey, what's so funny?
You!
Come on, Shigua. Don't make fun of our brother. He's just trying to be...
Yeah!
Hey, we've got it. Will you please finish your writing? Mama will be here any minute. Don't you want her to be proud of you?
What's there to be proud of anyway?
That we're practicing our writing.
Big deal. That's your idea of a good time?
Donghua, you know our family tradition. We've always been calligraphers.
What's that?
Calligraphy is the art of writing words so that they look very beautiful. And for many generations, it has been our family's honor to write down the official scrolls of all the magistrates of this province.
Boy, Sogwa, you sound just like our father when you say that.
What's wrong with that? I like it when Baba talks.
Hey, I said cut it out!
What's going on in here? It's time for bed.
But, Mama, we're not sleepy yet.
Nope, not sleepy.
Well, that's two of you. Where's Sogwa?
Here I am, Mama.
Sogwa, what are you doing up there? How many times do I have to tell you not to climb so high?
I'm sorry, Mama.
Now to bed with all of you. And Sogwa, please try to be more careful. Do you remember what happened the first time you climbed up high and got yourself into such trouble?
Yes, Mama, I remember.
Well, I don't remember.
That's because you were only a baby.
Don't call me a baby.
Donghua, be nice to your little sister.
But she was a baby then. She was barely born.
Donghua, I said...
I'm sorry, Mama, but sometimes she asks the silliest questions.
Donghua!
Okay, okay. Sorry.
I can't help it if I was so little I can't remember. So what did happen?
Oh, no. Not this story again.
Please, Mama, please. What happened?
Well, Sogwa, do you mind if I tell your story again?
Oh, that. Well, if you want to.
Well, all right then. Let's see. It all started one morning at breakfast. Come on now, children. We have to hurry, or your father and I are going to be late for work.
Yes, we must go. The master is waiting.
Why?
Pardon me, Donghua.
Why do you have to go? Why do you have to go and write down those ridiculous rules anyway?
What? What are you talking about, my son?
That is our job, our duty.
But don't you hate writing down the magistrate's silly old rules? Sometimes he's so unfair.
Donghua, it is not for us to say what is fair and what is not. We are only cats.
And very lucky cats, I might add. Look at where you live. Look at what you eat. Do you think the alley cats have it this good? Young man, I do not ever want to hear you talk like that again.
Yes. If you're ever overheard, we will all be tossed out in the alley. Or worse. Donghua, remember your place.
But...
No buts. Finish your breakfasts. We will be back later.
My dear, only 93 gold pieces from finding your people this week. 93!
What's wrong with 93?
Well, dear, there's nothing wrong with 93. Except, well... Except if we had collected more, then I would be able to have new robes made for our three beautiful daughters. I said, our three beautiful daughters! Now, where was I? Oh, yes. You see, my darling, you are, after all, the ranking magistrate in this province. And, well, your people expect your beautiful daughters, and of course myself, to dress in a certain regal style.
Yes, my lotus blossom, whatever you say.
Yes, exactly. So, it's quite simple. More rules, more rules, more fines, more fines, more money! For your beautiful daughters. Don't you agree?
Yes, of course. Anything you say.
Well?
Well?
Well then?
Well then what?
Well then, do it!
Yes, yes, all right, my lovely little lychee. Anything. Anything. Reader?
Yes, Your Excellency?
What new rules did we set forth last week for the good of my people?
Let me see, Your Grace. Your Grace, last week you banned laughing, dancing, telling jokes, any kind of celebration, and in general, having fun in any way.
Well, there you have it, my lotus flower. I think we have about covered it all. I really do not think there is anything left to ban.
Well, there's always singing.
Singing? What a marvelous idea!
And while you're at it, put an even bigger fine on it than usual. All that noise disturbs my beauty naps anyway. And those of your three daughters, I might add.
All right, all right. Let it then be decreed.
And not one moment too soon.
My delicate Chinese plum, if you will just allow me. Reader, royal cats, come forward so my word may become the law of the land.
Nigualai, come here. It's time to do your duty. We are ready, Your Excellency.
Yes, yes, all right. Let it now be decreed that there shall be no singing from dawn until dusk.
A very wise law, my dear. But is it strict enough?
A very good question, my capacious kumquat. A very good question. You know, I really hate it when those people sing at all. So let's just make it no singing period. Today's new rule. There will be no singing from morning until night and from night until morning. That is my word, and that is the law, by the order of His Imperial Excellency, etc., etc., etc. This rule will keep them quiet so I can at last have some peace. From now on, only I shall sing. Must not sing, must not dance, must not laugh or lose your pants. That's the rule, that's the law. Not allowed to say ha ha. If you do, night or day, woe is you, you have to pay.
Ahem. One would think you could get a little law passed around here without such a big fuss. Come, darlings, it's time for our mud baths. Before I leave, though, one more piece of business. Here are the names of those who already broke the rule today.
When it is dry, go read it to the villagers.
This is the worst rule yet. Look, he's even fined the cook just because he sang while feeding us our breakfast this morning. It's just not fair.
Remember what you told Dongua. It is not for us to say what is fair or unfair. It is just our job to write it down. After all, we are only cats. We cannot change the world.
We're not helpless just because we're cats. We can change the world. How am I gonna get down? I have to jump. This is not good. Now it says there will be singing. From morning until night and from night until morning. Wow, this is great! Singing all day long. This could be a good thing after all. Uh-oh. I've got to get these paw prints off of here. I've got to get out of here.
Well, now I see you've really gotten yourself in trouble.
Foo-foo, you found me. We Wait a minute. I thought you couldn't see so well.
I can see better upside down, and I can also see that you are, once again, a mess. So, what is it this time?
Ink. Ugh. Can you fly me to the pond to get cleaned up?
Ink? Ink? Ink doesn't come off with water, especially this ink. You better get used to those spots, because they're not gonna go anywhere.
Uh-oh. Oh, dear, I am in so much trouble.
Think of it as a fashion statement.
Not just for that. When I fell in the ink pot, I messed up one of the magistrate's rules. If he finds out what I've done, he'll put me out on the street. He'll put our whole family out on the street. I heard my mom say that to my brother today, and he was only mouthing off.
Hey, you, take it easy. Don't fall apart on me.
Quick, let's get out of here.
And done it. You are gonna be in so much trouble.
Thanks for the support, Dongwa.
Oh, sorry, but how... What... I mean, how did you get like this?
I fell into the ink pot.
You what?
Well, you see...
Mama and Bob are gonna be so...
Hey, Sagwa knows she's in trouble, and I'm gonna help her solve her little dilemma. In the meantime, you are making much too much noise! Noisy, noisy, noisy! It won't do us any good to draw attention to this little mess. And I need some peace and quiet to think and work out a plan.
So why don't the two
I know, leave. I can't wait to tell everybody how ridiculous you look all covered in ink.
Dongwa, don't say anything to anybody. Our whole family could get in trouble because of what I've done.
Okay, okay, okay. But you owe me one.
Will you please get out of here?
All right, all right.
Ah, yes, quiet at last. Now, where was I?
The plan. What am I going to do?
Oh, yes, the plan. Now, let's see. If we just...
You're 2 minutes late. Get the scroll with the new rules, take it into the village square, and read it to the people. Now!
Sagwa, keep calm. I'm going to fly down to the village and see what's going on there. I'll be back with a report before you know it. Jai Jin, my friend.
By order of His Imperial Excellency, I hereby decree that his word shall become law, and that the law of the land is that there will be singing from morning until night and from night until morning. It's true. It's true. See right here. The people must sing all day long.
What's this? Huh? What is all of this horrid, horrible, happy noise making? Really, my dear? How dare they disobey your rule?
Yes, how dare they?
Four hundred thirty-four, my dear, a new record. We shall be wearing clothes of gold by this time tomorrow if all this singing keeps up. It's almost enough to make one like music.
Why are all these people singing? Why are you singing? Didn't you show them my new rule?
But Most honorable magistrate, this is your new rule.
What do you mean this is my own rule? Who did this?
Yes, who did this? What are you smiling at? How can you even hear yourself think?
But listen, my wondrous water lily. Listen to those beautiful words. They are singing my praises. In all my life, my people have never said a kind word about me.
Why, my dear, in 30 years, I've never before seen you cry.
Well, in 30 years, my people have never called me kind. Imagine that. My kindness has caused them to sing. How very beautiful. Who's this? Oh, so you're the one who changed my rule. Mama Meow, Baba Meow, come here quickly. Look what your kitten has done. Because of what Sagwa has done, I want you to write 3 new rules. For the first new rule, I take back all the old rules. The people may now laugh and joke and dance and whistle from morning to night, from night to morning, whenever they desire. As to the second new rule, from now on, my village shall be open to all stray cats, and all cats shall eat delicious fish every day, as much as they wish. As to the third new rule, from now on, all Chinese cats shall have dark faces, paws, and tails, in honor of the greatest of all felines, Sagwa of China.
Wow, Mama. That was a really great story.
Well, they've already heard it. But thank you, Shigwa. And now it's time for you to go to bed, too.
But I want to hear more.
There is no more. That really was the end.
Wow. Sagwa did such a good thing.
Well, yes, Shigwa. In many ways, she did. But you know, she also did some things she shouldn't have.
Really?
Really. But here's the good part. Many times, we actually learn from our mistakes.
I didn't think about it that way. I guess Sagwa learned her lesson.
Everybody did, I think.
Even the magistrate?
Especially the magistrate. Now it's time to sleep. Tomorrow's another day.
And another adventure.
Oh, dear. You're already starting to sound like Sagwa. Oh. Sweet dreams, my little adventurer. You certainly know how to land yourself in a bit of trouble from time to time. But your heart is always in the right place.
I am a curious cat, and I'm always on the lookout for ways to have fun. Did you ever consider writing to be fun? Chinese writing is like picture writing. When it's done beautifully, it's considered an art as well. Then it's called calligraphy. It's like an abstract art. You don't have to understand Chinese to see its beauty. You can just look at it and enjoy. Some of the characters look like the word it means. Can you guess what this means? What about you? What do you think art is?
Art is like drawing and painting and coloring. If you make something really weird, it means abstract. First, I would make a circle. As you start out with a circle of a person's head, then I would make lines out coming from the circle. Then at the end of the lines, I would make squares and so on. And then I would make these curves from the squares and going to the next square. And then I would make swirls going into the circle, and that would make an abstract painting.
Now that's a great story. I guess people everywhere have an artist's eye. Look what these artists are creating in Jamaica. They are making tie-dye shirts. Tie-dyeing is one of the oldest dyeing techniques in the world. And guess where its roots trace back to? China! People often use their clothes to express themselves. Tie and dye is a skill and an art. People all over the world like to express themselves through art.
Whoa! Oh. What about you?
Shiqua, stop squirming. There, now you're all ready for summer. Okay, Sagwa's next. Sagwa!
I sent Sagwa to the village with a small scroll for the reader of the rules.
Well, looks like you're next then, dear.
Oh, no need, dear. I've already attended to my grooming.
And that completes today's rule from our most magnificent magistrate. Seems that there's one more ruling from the palace. The magistrate forbids anyone to build a campfire in the woods. The trees are as dry as kindling at this time of year, and he does not want any forest fires.
I can't go in looking like this.
Ow! It's stuck.
I know. I'll wash it off in the pond.
Sagwa, what have you got yourself into this time? Ah, playing in mud puddles again, I see. What you need is a good bath. Oof, no, what you need is a good trim. Now stop squirming. You don't want me to slip your tail by accident, do you?
He's a great cook, but a really bad barber.
Hey, nice haircut, Sagwa.
I just escaped great danger. I'm lucky to have any fur left after what I've been through.
Really? What happened?
I'd rather not talk about it. It was most horrible.
Oh, come on, Sagwa.
Tell us.
All I can say is that it happened far, far away.
When you were in the village?
No. Further.
Much further. In the far mountain woods.
Oh, really? And how did you get all the way there and back so fast?
I was kidnapped.
Kidnapped?
By who?
How?
Why would anyone want to kidnap you?
Who?
Who would do that?
Who?
A really bad a bad
some bad bats.
Huh?
I had just finished delivering a very important scroll to the reader of the rules when two big bats swooped down and swept me up into the air. Hey, what are you doing? Where are you bats taking me?
Top secret. No questions.
Hey, put me down. I know Fufu, and when he hears about this, he's going to be really angry.
You know Fufu?
Yes, and he's my best friend, too.
Ooh! Fufu, the biggest, scariest bat in the whole colony!
Yeah?
Then what happened?
Yeah, what? I'd rather not talk about it.
Aw, Sogwa.
You gotta tell.
Yeah, you gotta.
Well, then they dropped me.
And you won't believe who I met next.
Why, if it isn't a little meow, what's your name? I am Senlaw, the Rain Spirit Dragon. I live far up in the clouds. But I like to come down to Earth from time to time, too.
Wow, you met a dragon?
Come on, you weren't saved by a dragon.
Was too, and he said...
Oh, look at you. You're covered in pine sap and bark bits. I'm sorry, Sogwa. But that stuff will just not wash out. I'm going to have to give you a little fur cut. What's it like having fur? Must be nice and warm in the...
What? Rain spirit dragons don't spit fire.
Well, this one did. And fire is very dangerous in the woods.
Oh, my. Dreadfully sorry. Don't know what got into me. Maybe your fur.
You set a fire. The trees are as dry as kindling this time of year. That fire could spread to the whole forest.
Oh, dear. What do we do? What do we do?
I know. Fly down to the sea, get a big mouthful of water, and spray it all over the fire.
Great idea. And you're coming with me.
And I steered Senlong by his ears as we swooshed down to the sea.
Hey, what's up?
Sogwa was kidnapped by two bats, and then a dragon sneezed and set fire to a tree. And now they have to fly to the sea.
Whoa, back up, back up. Kidnapped by bats? What bats?
She'd rather not talk about it. It was most horrible. And when she told them you were her best friend, they laughed.
Well, that's really rude. They shouldn't laugh at you just because your best friend is a bat.
No, they were laughing at you, Fufu.
What? Me? Who were they? Fifu and Fofu?
No, there weren't really any...
I know. It was Fumfu and Fatfu, wasn't it?
No, I...
That was my call for the brave Fufu fighters. Don't worry, Sogwa. We'll find Fumfu and Fatfu and punish them good.
Oh, no. Wait, I don't want anyone punished because of me.
After what they did to you, Sogwa, the magistrate should order them never to enter the village.
And they should be sent to bed without their suppers. I wasn't really kidnapped.
What do bats eat for supper anyway?
You don't want to know.
I mean, if there's anyone to be punished, it should be me.
I know. I'll make them clean the bat cave from bottom to top. And boy, does it need it.
Fufu, I was not kidnapped by any bats. I'm...
Not kidnapped by bats? What do you mean? Oh, I get it. You can't talk. Those bats are still around here, aren't they? Huh, glad you got my message. We got a couple of bad bats in the area. You all spread out. Check the bamboo bushes, the lotus pond.
Stop! There are no bad bats, no dragon, no fire. I was so embarrassed about the holes in my fur that I made it all up. And once I started, I just couldn't stop.
You lied to us?
You mean, I called in the foo-foo fighters and there's no one to fight?
Of course, I knew you were making it up all along. Fire-breathing dragons.
And just why did those make-believe bats of yours laugh at me?
I'm sorry, Foo-Foo.
But how did it end?
What? How did what end?
Did you and Shenlong go to the sea in time to put out the fire?
There is no ending, Shigua. It never happened. Like Donghua said, I was just lying.
Well, you're not now. I mean, if we all know it's made up, the rest of it won't be a lie. Just a good story.
A really great story.
By the way, Sagwa, how did you really get those holes in your coat anyway?
Sagwa, are you all right?
We just overheard Cook tell Tai Tai he had to cut patches off your fur.
What on earth happened here?
I did the margin in salt water and a clay pot exploded all over me.
Wow! A clay pot exploded all over you?
Did a dragon do it?
No dragon. And no bats either.
So what happened? Tell us!
Well, there I was in the village, watching a potter turn a pot on his wheel. It went round and round and round and round, and suddenly, achoo! Bam! Blobs of clay flew right at me. Nowhere to hide. I was hit. Blob, 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 blob. You know my family. And just about everything in my life begins with them. In China, parents, grandparents, and ancestors are very important.
My great, great, great grandfather.
See what I mean? Traditionally, the Chinese were taught to obey and take good care of their parents. And so grandparents often live with the entire family. I actually think my grandparents take good care of us. I love spending time with my Yaya. He tells us stories. He makes us laugh. And he teaches us lessons he's learned in his long life. I love my grandparents. What about you? What do you do with your grandparents?
I sewed a panda at my grandma's house. And I sewed my grandma's skirt. And I do needlework. So my grandma sewed her doll. It was one of the prettiest dolls in her block. And she had to get hair. So, in the country. So she was chasing the calf around, trying to get the pretty curly stuff on the bottom. And she was running around with scissors chasing the calf. And she finally cut some and put it on her dolly's hair. She's not really that old, but not really that young, but she's, when it comes to playing, she's really young.
Now that's a great story. Look what this boy is doing with his grandfather in Alaska. Ice fishing. In Alaska, when winter comes, the land freezes. Ice fishing is the only way to get fish. This boy's grandfather knows just where to go. Thanks to Grandpa's experience and know-how, they catch enough fish to last for many meals. Kids all over the world cherish time spent with their grandparents.
What about you?
Look at me, King of the Hill!
You can't be a king. You're a girl.
for long.
Uh-oh! It's gonna hit Grandpa! Watch out, yeah! Hmm?
Hi-ya! Where did that come from? Aha! Uh-huh. You kittens playing games again, huh? Huh?
Sorry, Yaya.
It's all right. I was getting up anyway. Now then, Sagwa, what about that story you've been waiting for?
That'd be great!
Once upon a time, when we went exploring in the Forbidden Hills... Yeah, yeah. The cook, let's go see what he has for us. We'll finish the story later.
Meow.
Crabs and spices, grains and fishes, ducks and... There you are, old friend. And little Sagwa, too. I've been looking for months for something, and now I've found it. You're going to have a special treat, my dear old cat. Aha! 100-year-old fermented tofu. The oldest and best. Incredible dinner coming up for Yeye and Sagwa, too.
What's the matter, young one?
Stinky, stinky! And smelly! It's awful! P.U.
But it tastes so good!
Ugh, I guess you've got to be a grown-up cat to like that weird stuff. See you later, Grandpa.
I guess I'll finish my story later. Okay, Sagwa, how about we finish that story now?
Sure.
Now, where was I? Oh, yes, exploring the Forbidden Hills.
Is there more stinky tofu around here somewhere?
I don't smell anything. What's the matter?
I just want to sit over here.
But I like you next to me. Don't you want to hear the story?
It's just your... Oh, I forgot. I have to go play with Huang Huang in the alley.
But we've been planning this story for weeks.
Yeah, I know, but I've really got to go.
Oh. Oh, all right. Have fun.
I smell some 100-year tofu. I want some now. It's whetted my appetite.
But... Your magistrate, there isn't any more.
No more? Well, then get some more, and get it quick!
Oh, why do you look so sad? I'm feeling bad, too. I'm in big trouble, because now the magistrate wants some 100-year tofu, and it took me months just to find what we had.
Cook! Cook! Get that tofu now!
But why did you say that?
I don't know. I just thought it would be easier to tell him that I was playing with Huang Huang than...
Then what?
Here you are. What's wrong with Yaya? What happened?
I didn't want to tell him. He had smelly breath after he ate the stinky tofu.
So?
So, instead, she ran off before listening to his story.
I know. Oh, what am I going to do now?
Why don't you just, well, you know, tell him the truth?
You mean, tell him he smells like stinky tofu? Yeah.
Our friend the cook needs some help, so we are going to help him.
But I need to tell you something.
Okay, come on. We'll talk along the way.
Grandpa, I wanted to say about earlier. I was saying that, what are we doing?
Why, we're looking for some 100-year tofu, of course.
Ew, that stinky old stuff? Oh, no.
Oh, yes. The cook needs some for the magistrate.
Wow.
How will we ever find any 100-year tofu? We've got to try to help cook, but how?
I don't know. There's so many people, so many things, so many smells. I smell lychees. I smell fish. I smell flowers. I smell duck eggs.
You can smell all that from here?
Sure. Can't you?
No. When a cat gets older, they can't smell things as well as before.
So, you couldn't smell that stinky old tofu in the kitchen?
Not really, but I sure like the taste.
Oh, I understand now.
I have an idea. Maybe your sharp sense of smell can help in all the confusion.
How?
Just follow your nose, sniff around, and find some 100-year-old tofu.
Sniff out that stinky old stuff? Yuck!
Oh, well, if you don't want to help.
No, that's not what I meant. I want to help. Nope, nothing. Can't smell it. Not there. Let's go to the other side.
What is it? Did you smell some 100-year tofu?
Yep, right over there. There it is.
That's it. Wonderful. Well done, Sagwa. And there's Cook. Try and get his attention.
What are you doing here, Sagwa? What? What is it? Okay, I'll come with you. You found it! 100-year-old tofu! Oh, you wonderful cats! We'll take it all!
Thank you, Sagwa. That was very kind of you. You are a wonderful granddaughter and a fine young cat. Now, what have you been trying to tell me all this time? Go on.
I'm sorry I ran away from you before. I love your stories, really, and...
But if you love my stories, why did you run away?
Because that stinky tofu makes your breath stinky, too.
Is that all? Oh, now I understand. You didn't want to hurt my feelings by telling me my breath was smelly.
Yes.
Sometimes the truth is best. And I just won't tell you any more stories after I eat 100-year tofu, okay?
Great! So, you're not mad at me?
No.
Thank you, Yaya.
Well?
We have found some 100-year tofu, Your Excellency.
Wonderful! I'll have some now. I can't wait. Get cooking!
So, how about a story?
That sounds great, Yaya.
All right. Well, once upon a time...
And learning together is more than just good. It's great!
Doink!